they thought they might reach the corner of the earth and find dawn. If they, the people will travel from one place to another place, but in this place they were afraid to, they will fall down here. They will fall down. That's why the people not travel one place to another place. In 1590, a Portuguese sailor, Ferdinand Magalhães, started his long voyages of sea journey from Spain. One guy is Portuguese sailor. Portuguese means Europeans. Portuguese means European person. He started journey. What's his name, European person? Ferdinand Magalhães. Ferdinand Magalhães, he started journey from sea. From Spain. By water journey he started. He kept sailing in one direction. He kept sailing one direction. From here, one direction he kept sailing. After the 3 years, he reached the same place. After the 3 years, he reached the same place he has started, where he started. He had actually sailed around the world. His voyage proved that the earth is round like a ball. After the 3 years, he reached the same place. For that only, the Ferdinand Magalhães found it, the earth shape is round. Ferdinand Magalhães found it, the earth shape is round, not a flat, not a flat. In 1969, when the American astronauts Neil Armstrong and Edwin Aldrin landed on the moon. In 1969, when the American astronauts means the person who traveled in other planet, the person who traveled in the other planet, for that person we called astronauts. Neil Armstrong and Edwin Aldrin landed on the moon. The two person who landed on the moon, they took photograph of the earth from there. On the moon, he took the one photo, earth photo. The earth looked like a huge ball. This had cleared all the doubts regarding the shape of earth. They took photos now. Further photos proved that the earth shape is round, not a flat. The earth shape is round. Now, others are having doubts now. They all are cleared now. The horizons. Standing on the top of a high building, if you look. The horizon. Standing on the top of high building, if you look far, we will find that the sky and the land are meeting. If you stand on the top of the building, you will observe that the sky and the land will meeting. The sky and the land will be meeting. The place at which the land and the sky appears to meet is called the horizons. The place where the meeting, the land and the sky are the meeting, for that place we call horizons. For that place we call horizons. Every time we come closer to horizon, it seems to move further away. If we come to closer, the land and the sky will come to closer, not will see, but we are moving away. Actually, the sky and land never meet, they just appear to meet. Actually, the sky and the land are never meet, just they are appear to meet. It's not meet also, and they will never meet. For that place where they appear to meet, for that place we call the horizons. For that place we call the horizons. The coast. The place where the land and sea meet is called the coast. The place where sea and land meet, for that place we call coast. For that place we call coast. Standing at the coast and facing the sea, it seems that the dust at a far off distance, the water and sky are meeting. If you are standing on the coastal area, we see the water and the sky will going to meet. The water and sky are going to meet. It appears it's not meeting. It's not meeting. The water horizon. Now look They appear to meet only. They are can't meet and never meet. Here the children, the land and the sky will appear to meet. We call to horizon. For that place we call to horizon. And the place where land and sea, the place where land and sea will meet, the for that place we call to coast. For that place we call to coast. And the sky and water, the sky and water will meet, na, for that place we call to water horizons. Okay children, now you got all lesson, na? Okay, children, thank you.